نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد معدن الجود والكرم وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. Dear viewers, since last few days, the matter with regards to Junaid Jamshed about his utterings, the words what he used towards Umm al-Mu'mineen Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha, and also the way he mentioned that Nabi Kareem sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, while discussing with Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa, the way Sayyida Aisha behaved, he uttered in such a way which is not in the hadith. And also he said that even being with Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a lady cannot be changed. This is truly a wrong statement to say that even being with Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one cannot change the nature of a woman. Anyhow, with regards to this, many ulama of Ahlus Sunnah, they explain the reality, they mention the true context of hadith of Nabi Karim sallallahu ta'ala alaihi wasallam. And this person, Junaid Jamshed, repented from his statement, saying that I am an ignorant, I am a jahil, I am not an alim, I am not a mufti, so forgive me for this mistake what I did. Now the question is, he has repented from this statement what he uttered, which was not in the hadith of Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But has he repented from the corrupt beliefs of the Tablighi Jamaat, which is coming from the Deoband, and also the root of which is from Ibn Abdul Wahhab Najdi? If he is repenting from the belief of Tabligh Jamaat and from the beliefs of Wahhabism, then his tawbah can be considered. We will accept him as a person of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. He has not repented from the corrupt beliefs of the Wahhabism nor Deobandism. With regards to his repentance, scholars like Noman Ali Khan and Tariq Jamil, they say that when he has repented, you should forgive him. We should not make this a big issue. And even Noman Ali Khan referred to a verse of the Holy Quran with regards to Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an, of Surah Noor. I would like to mention that he has misquoted the context of the whole incident in order to defend Junaid Jamshed. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, his matter was with regards to his daughter Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha. And when Junaid Jamshed said, it refers to Ummul Mu'mineen, the mother of the believers and the Mahbuba of Nabi Kareem sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha. And there are fatwa of the ulama kiram, hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من سب نبيا قتل ومن سب أصحابه جلد. And Ibn Taymiyyah has recorded this hadith in his kitab الصارم المسلول على شاتم الرسول. And the fatwa of all the Aima Kiram, which is recorded even by Ibn Taymiyyah, saying that the one who insults Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the ruling is to kill him in the Islamic territory. He has no right to live, the one who insults Nabi Karim sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So this matter of Junaid Jamshed will be handled by the ulama of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Let them handle this. My point of argument, my point of view here is that no one has the right to defend Junaid Jamshed by misquoting the verse of the Holy Quran with regards only to Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa, but we have to consider the insult he made towards Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam by saying that even being with Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a woman cannot be changed. This is a major issue here. Therefore, Noman Ali Khan should not interfere in this matter. Rather, defending Junaid Jamshed, he should say that Junaid Jamshed, unless he study properly, he has no rights to do lectures. And also with regards to Tariq Jamil, who is the leader of Tabligh Jamaat in Pakistan, I would say he is truly an ignorant who doesn't know the basic belief with regards to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Have you not heard his clip where he says that Allah loves us so much that I feel, what he says is, I feel that Allah has descended and Allah is holding our shoulders saying that I am willing to forgive you. These are his statements of ignorance. Similarly, he used the word pagal, that is mad, for Sayyiduna Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu and for the Shuhada of Karbala, to say that they gave their life. Were they mad to give their life? Is this the word to be used towards Sahaba Akram and Ahlul Bayt Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in? And also he used the word old man for Sayyiduna Ibrahim ala Nabijina wa alayhi salatu was salam. The word he used was Buddha, which is very ugly to use towards a Nabi of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And at the same time, he insulted the childhood of Sayyiduna Imam Hassan radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala. So Noman Ali Khan and the rest of the scholars, they should keep quiet in this matter. Let the ulama of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah deal with this matter. Rather, supporting these ignorance, they should stop them from giving the lectures. And also we request Noman Ali Khan for him also to reveal, to expose his reality by just talking about the tafsir of the Holy Quran, and in between accusing Muslims to be mushriks, those who are respecting the blessed graves of the pious servants of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So they should come with their reality, rather hiding their real belief. This is munafiqat, this is hypocrisy. They should refrain from this and talk on the aqidah of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. We see today some scholars who speak in English, they come in such an attire that they don't want to talk on the aqidah. When they are questioned with regards to aqidah, they say, we don't want to go to the controversial topic. My dear brothers, this is not controversial topic. This is the basic belief of Islam, aqidah of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah, which is the creed. It has to be taught. If one asks this question, what is your aqidah? You should respond in a clear manner. If you say we don't want to discuss on these issues, that means you have munafiqat with you, which is totally wrong. Therefore, any people, any scholar, they should not defend Junaid Jamshed. Yes, if he has done tawbah, if he has repented, Allah is there to accept. But the order with regards to the one who insulted Nabi Karim sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is very severe. Accordingly, ulama of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah will decide what to do with regards to that. And even if the ulama decides for him to be here without giving any lectures in future, other people, they should not support or they should not defend Junaid Jamshed after this issue. And also they should stop Tariq Jamil from giving lectures. When the position of a leader is such, who is unaware of the aqidah, who is unaware even with regards to aqidah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, aqidah with regards to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, what can he teach us by talking in a polite manner and in between insulting the prophets of Allah, in between insulting the Ahlul Bayt and the Sahaba Karam Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in? This is not the sign of a scholar. Of course, it is a sign of a true ignorant. Therefore, these people should shut their mouth. And especially Junaid Jamshed, we request him, as he has repented, we request him to repent from the corrupt beliefs and to come to the fold of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. This is the path of Najat. May Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala unite all of us on the aqidah of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.